today we wanted to show you what we can find in a hunted out area. We're going to use our small coil. I'm using Equinox. I'm using a little 6-inch coil. And so let's go see what we find. Well, that's interesting. I guess that's brass. Or if it's got some writing on it or anything. Almost reminds me of like a suspender clip or something. Let me see if I can't get some writing off it or something. Let's see if you can see that or not, but it says registered, I think. Registered.
The other ever elusive sharps. Barely got that one. Crazy signal. Just about didn't dig it. Nuts. Nuts the way these things come in.
I might just leave that one in the dirt there. It'll stay.
I found a little coin right there. See that? So it's got some quarters in it. Let's see how many we got here.
Not bad, man. $3.
Boom. All right. I'm going to bet that's silver right there.
A quarter.
It's a silver quarter, all right. Let's see what year. 1940. I will take silver. Looks like it's gotten hit. I don't think by me, but I will take it. Dang.
What's left of a really old pocket knife? It's pretty well gone. I broke it, but. Oh well. Kind of a little hook. It's giving me a good iron signal, but with a good pop in there. I'm going to check the hole and see if there was anything else.
Right down there, got a little, I don't know if that's a Brett or a Tytac. I'm going to say Brett. But looks like it might have a little bit of turquoise in it. Have to clean it up when I get home, see if looks like it might have some writing on it. But pretty cool.
The 6-inch coil does it again. I got a whop of a signal down there about, maybe 6 or 8 inches deep amongst a bunch of iron. Check it out. Bayonet scabbard. Nice one too. It's in good shape. I'll have to clean that up. It's got the finial and everything all in complete. I cleaned it up a little bit. Ron came over here to check it out. Still got some wood in the end of it, which I can't believe. That is crazy. 160 years old and it's still got wood in it.
It's crazy, man.
Termites have not eaten it.
That's
up.
That's really nice, man.
It's the first one I found that didn't disintegrate.
It's like just over there.
Right there. Found a bullet right over there.
I did, man.
Scabbard tip right there.
Sweet. Just so you know, Tim's gonna be wondering what I just found because I've got my camera out. He's over there smiling. He's worrying. Is it an Indian?
I don't know.
No, it's not. It's round. It's got four holes. It's old. It is going to be a Civil War, probably underwear button. I'll have to clean
that
it up.
That one barely whopping in. That might be silver. Just barely hit a 33.
I think it is. Oh yeah, baby. That would be a 1902 Barber. Silver, baby, finally. I hadn't hit a Barber in a while. I like it. I'm feeling bad now that I shelved the Equinox for so long. Kind of got mad at it and been testing out a lot of other stuff. And Ron's made a believer out of me with it. Bam. 1902. I will take it. That's a pretty one too.
Wasn't very good signal, but it was bouncing around, but there's so much trash in here. I just pulled that out right there. You see it? All right. That's a nice drop sharps, man. Oh, it was bouncing, dude. It was
crazy.
15 to 23, dude. It just had enough repeating.
But it was a higher number.
It was higher, but it was like, just, I didn't know if there was a bunch of things in the hole. But, it's a short.
All right,
so we're going to wrap up. And, we had a pretty good day.
Yeah.
Just
a short afternoon.
Just fiddling around. Like I said, we wanted to try out these 6-inch coils on these Equinoxes, man. So,
here 100 times and
bam. Tell you what.
15 through the garbage.
They done good. I got me a little silver, 1940 quarters, some bling. That was some sort of Brett you saw. I'm pretty sure this is says registered. Pretty sure that's a what you call it, suspender clip.
Yeah.
Got this really old button, man. It's falling apart. Got me a little Civil War with the sharps. Gotta dig the bottom tops if you're gonna get a gold.
I dug a bunch.
A gold ring.
Get any gold.
But I got some clad. I thought that effigy thing was cool. Never seen that. I got $3 from this roll here. Somebody's remote control for the camera. Somebody's mad.
One of the times I was out here before, I found a dollar bill laying on the ground, and then you find that in
yep.
Almost the exact same spot.
Find $3, man. Tim got, in case we get lost, man, make a compass. Old pocket knife broken up. This is cool. This would be for like pulling some string through or something like that.
Hook,
I would imagine
yeah.
A little hook. That could be old. This was pretty cool. Tim probably showed it in his video, but it's got like leaves around there. I don't know what that is. It's very interesting.
You know,
is that a whistle? No.
I don't know. I thought it was the end of a gun, but it's cast. So, you know, like a bolt.
Yep.
But it's cast. And I remember Robert gave me some of these, and they were hooks for pulling laces or something.
Yep.
So that might be a lace hook.
So, that looks like, is that some brass or something?
It's came in like aluminum, but it's a little cap or something.
Nice little Ford emblem or key chain, probably. Tim got him some silver, man. 1902 Barber.
Been a
Congrats,
while.
Congrats, man.
Been a while on a Barber.
Got him a sharps, some clad, some bling. And so, this is the best find of the day right here. But this is a sweet. There's a finial. That's a sweet.
Bayonet
scabbard tip. And really, you know what, if Tim's just found a couple more of those, so you know, if you want to check that out in this video up here, then just click it and like it.
Yeah.